in the first go-round, so he will now come back and give the first summary speech. So let's welcome back now to the microphone, Shane Swan, our pro speaker.
Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? I see we're going to have a problem here. Yeah. But a lot of valid points were made. I would like to begin. She pointed out that our military is fighting for us. And I would like to say that I brought that up. Our military is fighting for us, and it's the exact reason that we shouldn't just be limited to these two choices. Another young lady came up and she said that on the ballot there's 13 options. Well, where are they? I have not seen many of those options in the news, or at least what is called the news, what we say is the news, Fox and CNN. So therefore, it goes to show you that they're affiliated with those parties and they have a stake in the election. They have a stake in making you believe that there's only Trump or Clinton as your options. I'd also like to clarify that I'm not saying to not vote. I'm saying that your vote doesn't matter because we're forced to think that we only have two options. Another young lady said that it was unrealistic to vote for a third party. Well, I'm saying it's unrealistic to only have Big Macs and nuggets. The ice cream machine is not broken, and I'm tired of hearing it. I'm tired of only seeing two people on the debate stage when there should be many more. Another young lady talked about Hitler and the election and how there were so many parties. But you also have to consider that there were very coercive elements in his campaign. He had a secret police in the Gestapo, in which he used to influence people into voting for him. Now, our means of coercion are a little more subversive now. We now have television screens and people on them telling us who they believe are the most viable candidates. People who are affiliated with those parties. And it brings us back to polarized party politics. They brought up points about Louisiana being finite and Democrat or Republican. But regardless of what you say, there's not just two options of Democrat and Republican. Even those platforms, most of us in this room would not agree 100% with them. Not 100%. Maybe we would pick and choose, but not 100%. So we have to keep in mind that that's why our vote does not matter. It's not because we shouldn't vote, but it's because we're forced to believe that there are only two options when there aren't. There were 13 candidates on that ballot to vote. Next week, there are going to be 13 candidates. So you have a week to learn about 11 more candidates, because I'm sure you haven't heard about that many.